Hey guys, I'm Josh Taylor, Product Manager for Light Towers for Genie. Today we're going to talk about light coverage and functional light coverage when it comes to your light towers. One question we get a lot is, how many light towers do I need for my job site? The answer is, it depends. OSHA provides guidelines for different types of work sites and the foot candle requirements that are suggested for those types of work. The most typical outside job sites require about 5 foot candles to be within the guidelines that OSHA provides. It's important to check with your local and state regulations to make sure that you are following the guidelines that are provided. One way to determine if you have enough light is to look at a light map. So light maps for light towers typically work like this. We have our light tower at our maximum tower height, which is 30 feet, and our lights tilted at a 5-degree angle. So you may see a plot that looks something like this. Everything inside the purple area will be illuminated to a level of about 0.5 foot candles. 0.5 foot candles is enough to notice that there's light there, but it's not considered safe enough to do any meaningful work. So you may see a second circle inside of this. This will be a zone of at least 1 foot candle. 1 foot candle, again, you notice that there's light, but it may not be enough light to effectively do your job while you're out on a job site. There'll be a zone inside of that that's about your 5 foot candle zone right there. So that is all the area that is meeting the requirements laid out by OSHA for the type of work that you're doing. So typically there'll be a grid, and you can find out how far that light is cast for length and for width, and you can determine how many light towers you need depending on the size of your job site. Typically there'll be one more area inside of this, and this is your 10-foot candle range if you have a requirement for that. Now you can change the coverage level or the coverage pattern of the light tower by adjusting the angle of the lights, the toe in or toe out of the lights, and the tower height. All of those are factors to consider when you're planning your next light tower job. I'm Josh Taylor, Product Manager for Terex and Genie Light Towers. Thanks for watching.